I am Rekha Chauhan. Today, I am going to discuss with you the very first chapter of Flamingo, that is, The Last Lesson by Alphonse Daudet. Alphonse Daudet was a French novelist and also a short story writer. In this story, he focuses the themes of linguistic identity, linguistic loyalty, language imposition. This story was set up when France was defeated. In this story, there are two main characters. One is Franz and the other one Mr. Hamel. Franz is a student and Mr. Hamel, he is the teacher. This story is very simple to understand. But if we will go deep inside, that is, there are always two levels. Being a literature student, a person should understand that whatever he is studying, he should see the two levels. One is subtle level and the other one is the surface level. So before I start with this chapter, it is mandatory to understand these two levels. When we talk about the surface level, that means the simple story. Whatever we are listening, we just take it in the same form. But when we say that the other level, the subtle level, that means we need to understand that what is hidden inside that small story. So now you understand that what are these two levels? And these two levels you have to keep in your mind whenever you are studying some text or you are reading or listening some story. In the story, The Last Lesson, as the name suggests, the last lesson. So this means in this lesson, something is highlighted. And what is highlighted? That the word suggests the last lesson. As I told you that there are two characters, Franz and Mr. Hamel. In this story, what happens? One day, Franz started for the school very late. He was conscious and also worried that he would be scolded by his teacher. When he reached the school, he was surprised because he could see a different scenario. And when he was coming to the school, he saw that a huge crowd was gathered near the bulletin board. He was surprised. This shows that some news is there. But he was not aware of this fact. And when he reached the school, he found a different scenario. Earlier, when school used to start, there was always some hustle and bustle. But today, there was a complete silence in the school. Or I should say, peace prevailed in that area. Friends saw that the class was on, the teacher was inside, and all the students were there. He entered the class. He was very sure that today, his teacher would scold him. But to his utter surprise, what he noticed? His teacher, Mr. Hamel, he just told him, "Friends, go and take your place. We are going to start our today's lesson." Friends went and he took his seat. Another thing which he noticed, that the teacher was in a different attire. He was wearing a beautiful green coat, silky cap, frilled shirt, and that was embroidered. He was surprised because the teacher used to wear such attire on special occasions like prize days. It was the time to start with the lesson. The bank benches were occupied by the villagers. Earlier, the villagers, they were not in the class, But today they are present because they have come to respect their own country and also to thank their master for 40 years of service. Now, before starting with the lesson, Mr. Hemmel asked friends, "Friends, you remember the lessons of participles?" Friends stood up and he was little bit of in a confusion state. He didn't speak a single word. Today, this teacher, he didn't scold him. He confessed that the mistake was of the parents and the teacher. Mr. Hemmel started with the lesson. "Today is my last lesson." All were surprised. This boy's friends, now he came to know why there was a different scenario, and the day, the moment he started for the school, he observed so many events, changes that were there in the environment. And now he realized. Mr. Hemmel continued. "Now, in place of this French language, German language would be taught in the future. So today is your last French lesson." Friends understood the whole scenario. On the other side, teacher continued with his lesson. "This French language is the most beautiful language in the world, the clearest language, the most logical language. So we should respect our language and also try to safeguard this language. Our language is the key to the present. Because as we know that France was defeated, and now this story highlights that the people were not allowed to use their language anymore. Now, in this position, friends was regretting that he didn't learn his own language. When he got the opportunity to learn the language, he didn't utilize that language, and today is the time when they are not going to learn this language anymore in the future. All were depressed, all were sad. And here, the teacher, Mr. Hemmel, after explaining the importance of French language, he stood up. The very moment the clock struck 12, it was the time for midday prayers. Mr. Hemmel, he tried to speak something, but he could not. Something choked him. What he did? He stood up and he wrote something on the blackboard. That was, "Vive la France." That means, "Long live France." With this, he made a gesture to inform the students that the class was dismissed and they might go. Now here, this simple story, a simple scene of the classroom, but this is the surface level. We understood the story that what happened, a simple scene was created, a class was on, and in that class, the last lesson of French was taught. This is the surface level. Now, to understand the essence of the story, we need to go to the subtle level. What is hidden inside this story? This shows the very important theme of the story, that is linguistic identity. But here, in this story, it has been shown that the pain that was inflicted on the people because now they are not allowed to use their language anymore. Their right to speak their language is no more. They are forced to use some other language. This is called language imposition. Language loyalty. They can't be loyal to their language. They are not allowed to use their own language in their own country. Language imposition. Another language will be imposed on the people. This story last lesson shows that people of a country are forced to use some other language. In a way, they are not allowed to use their own language, no more freedom of their own language. It is the language which binds us all together. Therefore, this story, the last lesson, has universal appeal. And today, when we are studying this story, then we have to focus on this language identity, or I should say linguistic identity. We need to understand that our own language is our own identity. And this is all for today. Thank you.